Hey there, YouTubers. All right, so in this video, I'm going to put together this, however you say that, HLONONE, H-L-O-N-E. It's probably Chinese, I'm sure. But, so let's get started. We need wood dowels in this thing. And I'm going to build this thing upside down, I guess, is what would appear. So it looks like, without looking at the directions, these holes are probably in the back, right? And those are where your monitor cables and stuff are gonna go. So we'll keep the instructions out, because not that we're just gonna screw these videos up. So three dowels, and there is no glue. So that's kind of a bummer. Actually, we should add something else to put it together than that, but they wanted to keep the top surface nice and flat, right? So put the dowel in, and they don't include a hammer, so I'm assuming you should be able to do this by hand. So that dowel did not go all the way in. We may have to get a hammer or use my hand. Okay, it's in. So, careful how you're putting this together, because you could probably scratch the hell out of it. All right, so the dowels, and hopefully you can just press these together just like so, right? And if you're lucky, there's no gap. I've been doing, putting together some wood flooring, and I hate seeing little gaps when I can't get the wood to completely go together after I bang on it. All right, so that's in, folks. Hopefully it's correct, right? Now we need a couple of our supports that are going to go, longitudinally. Looks like number five. So these look to be the bigger supports. Think. And this is where the directions honestly look like they're going to be not the best in the world. That didn't line up like that. Okay, so that lines up like that. And so it looks like you have two different ones. I don't know why they didn't just put one big ass one in there. The box, I guess, you know, they try to save money, right? All right, so we're gonna insert this into here. And the drawing, the picture kind of sucks. It's kind of hard to tell what the hell they're doing in the picture. Hopefully we won't screw this up, but it would appear this is threaded, so it's got to stick up. And these don't really snap in good, but for the most part they line up with the holes. Well, actually maybe not. So this thing, to get it to line up right, it's going to be a little loose. Jam the one in all the way, but that's not the way to go, it would appear. So we have two of these, folks, and they're actually different, it looks like. Where are they? Okay, make sure when you do this that the threaded part is up top, right? It doesn't go all the way through. There's the through holes, and then there are welded holes on here. And that makes these things, that would appear to be identical now. Now this part, same deal. And we want to make make sure all these line up good. Okay, so there's that. Now you're going to fasten it with 30 millimeter by 8, which is in your package. And lo and behold, so the directions say 30 millimeter times 8, but of course, when you look at the package, it tells you the length, right? And there's two 30 millimeters, but there's M6 by 30, so it's got to be these. So we're going to drop these in. And hopefully they'll line up. So this is where you're going to need your Allen wrench. And once I put this in, oops, sorry. Don't try and put it in the threaded hole that's on the support. That's not where it goes. Okay. All right, so I am going to get these all in. Then I'm going to get the Allen wrench out and tighten them up. And you know, I was going to edit this video, folks, to remove how long it takes to do this, but you know what, we'll just put this video up. You know, realistically, this is how long it's going to take you, right? If you watched it, the length of the video, and you have patience, I guess. Don't take any breaks, so don't over tighten that. I could hear something starting to crack a little bit. That's a little scary. Probably the top surface, maybe. You can hear it there too. Yeah, I'm really curious why they put gloves in there for. Interesting. We gotta do this one. So my first impression, besides the legs looking really lean, the actual surface itself looks nice. The mere fact that it is particle board, all right, you can probably see through the hole. So, you know, of course that obviously sucks, right? But unless you spend a crap load of money, that's what you get. Let me see if we can, you guys can't even see those final holes. There we go. I don't know if they're, I didn't see any caps, but the ends of these square tubings, you know, maybe they'll be covered up. All right, so that's in, folks. Is it time for the legs? It is time for the legs, folks. All right, so the square tubing does have, whatchamacallit in it. It's a threaded hole. Now this is important that you put the right leg on the right side, right? And this is where the box, looking at the cover of the box. Okay, maybe not the cover of the box. Does it cover the box? Yeah, the cover of the box. And you may be able to see that in the background, but so the curved side is the front, right? That would be here. And then our leg is going to, you know what? These are symmetrical, so it doesn't matter, but you do need to point it in the right direction. And so this is in the back, all right? So this will go here, And then we need our 35 millimeter by 4 screws. And these are the, it appear to be these long ones. Because they're the only 35 millimeter ones left. So it's going to get 4 in from the side. And eventually there'll be a cross brace. So I'll let you guys see it from this angle first. And then we'll look at it from that side. So this is definitely a spot where you wish you had a power tool to do this, folks. Or a bit on your power tool bit. So I'm kind of surprised that they've got this fastener in here so close to the other fastener. And then of course this Allen wrench is not going to be long enough to just continually do this. You'll have to take it out. And you'll see better when we get to the other side. But yeah, this was, God, what did I pay? 90, 80, 90, 100, somewhere in there for this. And I think I'm going to find out that I should have got the 62 so I could have triple monitors on it. Ideally, I'd have a desk so big that I could put three 43-inch 4K 120 hertz monitors on it, right? Wouldn't that be awesome? Now I do have, I actually do have one. Wow, this screw does not want to go in. So for the sake of time, I may just jump over the other side rather than fighting this one. Because either way, it looks like it ain't going to work. But yeah, I have a Sony Bravia 4K 120 hertz TV that is incredible for gaming. I much prefer that over any other monitor I have, even the higher frequency ones. I just think the picture quality, the colors are better. So be pretty awesome to game with three of those. But truth is, being a smaller channel, I have a lot of monitors, but we don't have too many that are the same that I could put three side by side. All right, so that's good. Now we're gonna do the other side and try and give you guys the best angle of this. So if you look in there, you can see threaded hole. I didn't put the thing on the back of these. Now if you have a bit that you could do this with your power drill, I would say go for it after you get a few threads on here. So that one's going to be really tight as well. So hopefully we'll get this in. So if this screw was only an inch longer and was, this Allen wrench was an inch longer and had a had a longer arm on it, so you could really torque these down. It would be perfect. Black and the light, of course. Alright, so that one is nice and tight. Bring in the secondary light. So I saw a wrench in there. I'm not even sure where, at what point we're going to need that. I hope we don't, actually. I hate those little wrenches. So this side, way easier, right? The installation. And I did not get this for free, just so you know. I did pay for this with my own money. Or maybe actually from Amazon. My Amazon links probably paid for this, but it was a good month for those. Definitely worth having those down below. And if you guys enjoyed this video, please buy this through the link down below. Okay, so that's that, folks. Now we have more stuff to do here, which will include the stabilization bars. You would think. Okay, so they really don't spend a lot of time showing you the stabilization bar. And oddly enough, I don't see the second one. Oh no, folks, you put it on backwards, and there are two stabilization bars. Ay, ay, ay. So I gotta take this off and flip it. Or one of these has to be flipped. It actually looks like it's probably the other side. Wow. Alright, so we are going to pause this while I fix my mess. So I may forget to edit the video where I realized that I put this in backwards. So if I don't, somebody, if you're watching this, and that could be anybody, please comment down below, because in YouTube's YouTube studio, I can go in and edit that whole portion. Alright, so we are putting this side on and putting the screws in, and we'll use our own lunch. And so this probably took at least a couple more minutes longer, because yours truly put it on the wrong side. Easy enough to do, right? That's why it's always probably a good idea to watch these videos, as long as they're done right. Now, the thing I did notice right away, I was like, oh gosh, there's no way that stabilization arm's going to work if I can't reach the threaded hole from there. So and I do believe you will need that threaded arm, or threaded, excuse me, that stabilization arm on here.